Kerala Minister K.T. Jaleel has spoken to CNN News 18. He had a conversation with Neetu Raghukumar where he said that one of the passengers who is dead is feared or suspected to be COVID positive, and that all the people who are responsible or who are involved in the rescue and relief efforts have been advised by the health department to go into quarantine as a precautionary measure. Listen in.
Yeah, total 19% were killed.
That has been officially confirmed.
Yeah,
and sir, anyone 19, affected?
19 is confirmed.
Confirmed.
13 in the government medical college.
Okay.
4 in the MIMS hospital.
Okay.
And 2 in the baby hospital. 15% are seriously injured. They are in different hospitals. Rest of them have minor injury.
Minister, has anyone been tested positive for COVID so far?
Out of 18, the results came out, then 18% out of 13, 8% the result came out.
Huh.
It is negative. One is suspected,
okay.
But not confirmed.
Not confirmed, okay.
Neetu live with us. Neetu, you said you had this conversation with K.T. Jaleel, and he has more or less maintained the same line. The death roll is 19. One of them is COVID. One of the passengers who's dead is suspected to be COVID positive, and that everybody has been advised to go into quarantine, everybody involved. But this does compound problems and, of course, the treatment issues, because now they will have to test and ensure that everybody is COVID negative. They will have to collect samples from everyone.
See, right from yesterday, right from the time this accident happened and when locals rushed to the scene to help with the rescue operations, the health department as well as the district administration knew that this will compound problems, because these are people who had to be under quarantine. These are people who had come in from Dubai and they had to be in quarantine for 14 days. And it's basically at the airport, a health checkup is also done, and that's where they look for if any of them have symptoms and they'll be taken to the hospital. None of that was possible on the ground because of the accident, and priority was given to save lives. Within about two and a half hours, most of these people have been taken outside. 7:40 it happened. By 11 o'clock the entire rescue operations was over there. So a lot of locals had rushed to the site for helping people. We even saw people standing at the hospitals late in the night for giving blood, basically for donating blood for all those who had been under treatment. So that is how the locals have come in and helped when it comes to all the rescue efforts. So it is known that they will have to keep all these people under observation, because this is an area which is seeing a spike in COVID cases, and also they have come in contact with people who should have been under quarantine. So they will be observed, test will be done. What the district administration has said is that they will be testing all these people who have been injured and are in hospital. So
right.
That process has already begun, is what we are understanding, Anand.
Well, thanks for that update, Neetu. And Manu Bharat, we're going to take a very, very short break. But on the way out, here's a quick reminder. Celebrate true financial freedom as we are entering into the Independence Week with Money Control.